it's like, I forget which civilization it is, but they have one where it's like, your people can defend themselves on the sea when they're embarked. That would be so helpful. Because those barbarians just, like, wreck your people if they're not escorted by someone.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, no, I worked so hard on that. Oh, bitch.
Yeah, just name my third city.
I've yet to name any other city. I just have Fall Rock Shireson. I don't think I'm going to name any other cities, because that's when you get attached to the cities. And then when they burn to the ground via the Urquois.
Don't worry, we can take out the Iroquois.
The Urquois.
Urquois, whatever.
Urquois.
Be right back.
Okay. Well, alright, what do we have here? Warrior, get in there. I don't know where I'm going to situate these guys. That'll be fun. Nowhere better to put them than somewhere in my territory. So, how are you people and you nice people enjoying this series? Don't forget to like and subscribe and discuss topical things in the comment and then rage at each other because you have a slight difference in opinion. Welcome to
and
the
And just
internet.
To get you started, PewDiePie sucks. Not really, I love you, kids.
Oh dear. All the internet rage. Oh man. Just you wait. One of these times, I'll remember your email. And then I'll be like, send your angry messages care of whatever the heck your email is. I don't remember.
Lewis@lovehog.com.
Yes, of course.
That's all of our emails.
All of our emails. Send your hate mail to that.
Especially Keegan and Vix.
Yes. All of the yes. Oh, look, they're finally building a road between Washington and Fall Rock Shireson. Took them long enough. Well, now I have ships that can't do anything because the Iroquois are blocking off any potential, like, exploration areas. Freaking Urquois. Oh, I have 8 horses. I just noticed that. I never have horses at the beginning. And apparently there's a ton of them. 2 here, 2 there, 2 here.
Here a horse, there a horse, everywhere a horse, horse.
4 there. And these are all outside of my territory. I've got 4 here and 4 here in my territory. Just got
nice.
All of them. Got all them.
Horses.
Horses, yes.
That's weird. I don't have samurai.
I think they're long swordsmen. Or swordsmen.
Long swords? Yeah. They're supposed to replace swordsmen, but it just says swordsmen. It doesn't say samurai.
Maybe it's long swordsmen.
I don't know.
It could be. Because those samurais wiped me out last game. And there's no way a regular swordsman would have been able to do that. Something is long swordsmen.
Alright.
I have no idea what... Come to think of it... Aw... There's no way that I can check cannon there. I want to know what my custom units are.
You could click off. Oh, yeah. I have to research steel. Wow.
I'm just kind of researching things as my... people are probably going to judge me for this, but I just kind of do what my advisors tell me. I'm a very passive player. I just, like, agree with what they tell me to do.
Yeah, I get that.
Because, like, I don't have an agenda. It's just kind of survive and build up a nice army and then take over the world at some point.
Right.
You didn't hear that last part?
No, I
These
heard that last part.
These are not the droids you are looking for.
I'm a Jedi like my father before me.
Oh, you completed the Oracle. I don't even know what good that is, but I want it. I'm gonna take it from him by force at some point. Just you wait.
I'm pretty sure she's just a psychic.
Who is?
The Oracle.
Oh. Yeah. I'm gonna wait until our borders are, like, clashing. Then I'm just gonna take this guy down. I'm gonna take this punk out. Except he's advancing fairly quickly, so I might not get the chance to do that.
At all.
Oh, well, I'm gonna defend my coastline with all my triremes that I have just laying around now that I can't explore anywhere else.
Defend the coastline from invaders that don't exist.
Not yet, but they could be.
Maybe it's about it.
Lurking in the shadows.
Getting to Washington. When's my settler being done? Oh, it's done.
Sweet.
Settle over there. Not even giving you a military escort. You don't need one.
No, not this early in the game.
There's nobody over there. I know where all the barbarians are. Their camps are gone. I took them all down. And right. As soon as one pops up, I'm taking it out.
Yeah, it's like a zit.
I don't mess around with that stuff. Yeah, it's like a zit. The longer you let it sit there, the bigger the problem becomes. Perfect metaphor.
Thank you.
And it explodes in blood and weird stuff.
Right.
Now we're going into weird territory.
Hello, gentle viewers, and welcome to the weird side of YouTube. Enjoy your stay and watch such videos as Orphan Tears and...
That's the only video YouTube on the poop. Weird side I can think of.
YouTube poop, or there's that one of, there's Krispy Kreme.
I don't know what any of these are.
You remember Krispy Kreme? He's the rapper from down south. No. He's this weird rapper kid. He thinks okay. He's really cool.
I was watching, The World's Dumbest or whatever on True TV. It was like Hillbillies. Mm-hmm. And first off, there was a guy who, like, hooked 6 packs of beer into his nutsack and lifted it by his nutsack. That was
disturbing. Oh my god.
Disturbing. But there was this one guy. He was like the whitest redneck ever. And he's like rapping in this video for a salvage shop. It was ridiculous.
Yeah. He's now, like, don't get us wrong, like, gentle viewer.
It's a steal, not a deal. Like, dude, go away.
Now, don't get us wrong, gentle viewer. White people can rap. Eminem is proof of this.
Eminem is the only proof.
That's true. But that's I guess so.
Eminem's the only proof that white men can rap. And we should leave it at that. Oh,
but the only reason why Eminem is so popular is because the dude is a genius.
Yeah. I like a lot of his, like, early music and recent music.
Like, so you like all of his music?
No, like, I kind of like early music where it wasn't so much, like, drugs
angsty?
And murder and all that stuff. And then more recently, it's like he got out of rehab and he's like piecing his life together and stuff.
Yeah, now he's a dad, so he's very depressed.
That's what happens when you become a father. So my warrior died a few turns ago, and I'm sad. He just like, I was like, it was like, you're gonna win this battle. I'm like, all right, go, dead.
That's how I feel when I lose a Pokemon battle.
It's like, you can do it! Dead.
I believe in you, Pikachu!
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 Ah, my knee! That's my knee! Ah! Ah, man! Why didn't you evolve me? Because I love you, Pikachu! Because you want me to lose? Ah! Look, I'm sorry, man. You did this! You could have just walked away! But you didn't. Why didn't you feed me anything but puffins? I need nourishment. Well, we don't eat Pokemon. We don't kill Pokemon. We do. We do it for you. Oh, my God. Aaron Hansen.
Oh, my God. Oh, sweet. I discovered iron, and there's an entire resource of 6 iron right next to where my cities are placed.
Nice.
Right next to Falrock Shireson.
But, like I was saying, Egoraptor, he is amazing. He is my god. No, he's not my god. Joss Whedon.
Awesome. Sexual lobster.
Actual lobster?
Sexual lobster.
Oh.
Look him up.
I have not heard of him.
Made such videos as Quest of the Manwhore, Dance of the Manwhore.
This sounds amazing. Why have I never heard of this gentleman?
Parody. It's a song about making a parody.
Nice.
Like, I'm gonna make a parody. Parody, parody, parody.
Have you ever heard...
He actually is like... I forget the line, but he's like, because YouTube is run by Puritans. I was like, whoa!
Puritans?
Yes. Because they censor everything on YouTube.
Yeah.
Except for fuck, shit, tits, and bitch.
That's true.
Suddenly the internet does not like this video.
I wonder if I'm going to get flagged for quoting Poke Awesome.
Probably not. As long as it's not Sega.
Oh, yeah.
Crap. I said Sega. They might flag us for that.
Well, then let's just get it all out of our system. Sega. Sonic the Hedgehog. Sonic the Hedgehog. What else did they make?
Sonic Adventure 2 Battle.
That's right. Sonic Adventure 2 Battle.
That game. Right. That game. I don't know if you ever played that game. But but I spent more time in that game raising my chows than I did actually playing the real game.
Oh, absolutely. The rest of the game is god-awful, except for raising the chow.
I mean, I played the rest of it long enough to unlock some characters to raise my chow with, and then I would just spam through, like, the first level as Shadow and just get all of the crystals to, level my chows up and just fight with them, and oh my gosh. All my time was wasted on that game in just raising chows. They're not even real things. But, and then, trying to figure out how to... I don't know about the rest of you people, but I end up having to, go online to find, how do you unlock the heaven and hell looking places and things like that. And once I unlocked them, it was beautiful.
Yeah, it's totally worth it. But it's sad when the core of your game doesn't stand up to what's basically taking care of nothing.
It's basically Neopets.
It is. It's worse than that. It's Webkinz.
Oh, God.
You remember those?
Don't
I do.
Start. No.
All right, back to Sega. What's the last decent game that Sega made?
I don't know. Did they make Total War games, I think? Those were all pretty good games. I'm not gonna lie. I did enjoy those quite a bit. I actually have Rome Total War, Battle Pack. Yeah, I have it right here. Let me just end my turn. The Total War Battle Pack comes with Rome Total War, Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion, Medieval Total War 2, and Medieval Total War 2 Kingdoms. Or no, maybe it's Medieval 2... shut up. Shut up, Internet. You don't own me.
Technically, they do.
I loved these games. Even though... because they didn't have a... They don't have a system that, tells you when you haven't moved your units. So half the time, you forget that you were in the middle of, invading somewhere. And so that really just kind of irritates me a little sometimes. But other than that, amazing games. Like, really straight up strategic and beautiful.
Yeah, but when did that come out? Like, 04, 05, maybe?
I want to say a long time ago.
See, that's my point. Sega hasn't made any really amazing game.
I don't know. I heard Shogun Total War was a pretty good game.
Did they make that?
I think. I would assume since it's Total War, but I'm probably wrong. Where does it say... crap.
Are you sure that Sega made Total War? I don't know.
Well, I know they made Total War games because it says Sega on the case. All over it.
Really? I didn't
Sega
know that.
Everywhere. All
That's
the
weird.
Segas. I have no idea when this game came out. I'm actually...
Anyway.
We're playing Civ 5, and I'm just staring at this case, trying to desperately to find out what year it came out.
Well, do me a favor and hit... oh, there we go.
Yeah, sorry, I wasn't taking my turn. I forgot.
That's alright.
Dad, there we go. I got Swordsman, and now I'm just wrecking Barbarian face.
Nice.
Yeah, it says... Oh. Rome Total War is the... blah, blah, blah. Strategy game. 2004. Yeah. It's been a while. It's been a while since they put out anything decent.
Right.
Sorry, Sega, you're gonna flag this, but deal with it. Right.
Put out. And as long as we're still on the topic of Sega, I cannot believe that they made Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games.
Oh gosh, that's serious. And they got a sequel at like the Winter
Two
Olympics.
Sequels.
Two?
Yeah, 2012.
Oh my gosh.
Right. Right.
Okay. When was the do you own a Wii?
I do own a Wii.
Okay, when was the last time you saw a good, like, real game for the Wii?
The last time I saw a good, real game for the Wii. There was Donkey Kong Country Returns, which was okay, but furiously hard.